guys, I am just waiting to get started. I may have to adjust the size of the chessboard after the stream starts, for real. Let's see. In any case, you're not going to get too stressed out about it. Just throw up some music sitting in the background. Let's see. Okay, it's not in there. I hope the music can be heard. Yeah, good. Excellent. I wasn't sure. I have Will's stream in the other laptop here on the side, but we'll have to see if I keep it muted. I reckon I will, because I want to use my own brain, not pick out his brain about my moves. It would be kind of silly. But by all means, let me know if the music is too loud and that if it blocks the commentary. So, and would be nice to know which one you prefer. Of course, I will be recording this and putting it on YouTube. Eventually. And while I wait for the games to start, I'm going to get some coffee. As you know, I'm a coffeeholic and I'm proud of being it. So, hang on. Case. Okie dokie. Coffee. Oh, we have started the game. And I'm already half a minute in. Nice. Okay, excellent. Thank you. Fantastic. Okay, again against me, I face 1d4. And there are a few options here. I have been playing knight f3 recently. Knight f6, I mean. And I have been following that up with g6. I've been following it up with e6. I'm wondering, should we go for Jinji Indian? But that's a kind of a opening that I don't really know. We could go Bogo Indian, because if I go here, he comes here, I follow it with this, he comes with the knight out here, because he doesn't really like playing against the Nimzo. But I can go for the Bogo Indian. But I don't know any theory there either. So I think, let's throw the Dutch at him. I know a bit of theory in the Dutch, but I'm pretty sure that he will make me regret it eventually. But the first game I beat him was actually in the Dutch defense. So, will be interesting to see. So, we have Tors in chat. So we have a moderator there to take care of any bastard spammers, which is very handy. And then of course myself. Other names that I see there, I have no idea what they are. Could be some spiders or something like that, some search spider. Okay, but I had like two different followers coming into my stream 9 days ago. I can't even remember if I streamed 9 days ago, but it is entirely possible. Fleidner 01 and Quillen Nation. So I thank them for it. So let's see how it goes. I have this music on repeat, and when I put it on YouTube, the guy who wrote the music and his band, they receive the royalties, which I am absolutely fine with. Phil Henley, who is the main guy in Wings of Pegasus, he actually recorded this video in F5. The thing is, the plan is, especially the way I play it, I tend to play E6, Knight F6, Bishop E7, Castle short, Queen E8 to get out there, and the whole plan hinges on getting in this kind of structure if white tries to go for e4. So that's basically how it goes. And yeah, this song, Phil Henley made a video of it where he was just walking around in London on a pretty cold day, just in a t-shirt and leather pants, and had a guitar and everything, just making that video, and he had no problems whatsoever in London with the police or anything like that, and eventually he released it. So I decided to buy his CD from him, both in digital and the CD, the physical form. So that was very handy. So after he plays here, I will probably go for E6 first, so he doesn't have this bishop to G5 business. But he might actually go for this kind of attack, and it's been a long time since I looked at that, but I'm supposed to take, I think. And if he does that and tries to go with a check out here, then I will blockade and then hit him with this. So it will be interesting to see how he responds to the Dutch. So, my laptop, the other laptop is muted now. There was one guy I played once who pushed D5 on me here. And to be honest, I think the move is just to play knight F6. Nothing to stress about. Okay, no nasty notifications about dropped frames or anything like that. That's good to know. I hope the updates to Streamlabs has worked the way I want to. Let's see. One video capture device is okay, he goes for that. Hey Matt, welcome to the stream, my friend. Let's see, I want to activate it again. Okay, now we have it as it should be. And then just lock it up so there's no nonsense going on. So yeah, give you a little shout out there. So, yeah, it will be interesting to see how this goes. Hey, you're welcome, man. Absolutely welcome. Absolutely welcome. I might actually be willing to do that. When is that one, Matt? Yeah, he might go with a knight h3 line, but I'm not too worried about that. I have faced it once before and I got completely crushed. Next Saturday, 1:30 p.m. New York time. That's 7:30 my time. That is entirely possible. But you may have to send me a reminder, but I will throw it into my calendar here, so just to see how that goes. At least I have it there. Yeah, I had already calculated it, so that would be 7:30 p.m. It's 7 p.m. right now, so. Hey, anonymous player, thank you, man. Will be interesting to see how this game against, because if he goes for this line and then pushes, then I will just push past. Yeah, excellent. Yeah, it's kind of annoying when it happens, man. What can we do? We just have to... Yeah, absolutely, man. Absolutely. Sounds great. Are you playing on Leeches then, or... Yeah, okay. Fantastic. Fantastic. Yeah, group simul, yeah. So you want me to be one of the players or one of the enlisted opponents? I can take on the weaker ones. Yeah, I'm game for that, man. Absolutely, I'm game for that. Yeah, I'm going to work on getting more active on in streams and playing more. So hopefully we'll get something fun. And of course, you have to expect some crazy play. Yeah, sounds good. So how many opponents are you planning to set up for? Yeah, sounds great. 15 to 25? Absolutely fantastic. I mean, my biggest private simul was like 17 boards. And I lost 5 games. I won 10 and I had 2 draws. And I had a headache for a week. I was a complete wreck afterwards. So I know what Sladgie is going through here in this one. or as he is, as he calls himself on leeches, Sparkle Horse. Yeah, I was completely wrecked. I was not easy. Yeah, but as I already know, Will Paschall, who is the streamer Sladgie on Twitch and Sparkle Horse on Leeches, he is moving house this week, so he won't be streaming. And I am planning to go on when I have time during days when he usually streams, which would be Monday, Wednesday. And I can't remember if he streams Thursdays. I have to check his schedule and maybe contact him there a little bit about it. Yeah, he streams Thursdays. He is analyzing analyzing viewer games, especially subscribers. View of the mic, because it will go really bad really fast if it's allowed to stay there. Oh, is Orsito in the house? That would be a lot of fun. I haven't seen him online for a very long time. Next up is Castle, then probably this, even though he, I'm not sure if he goes for this, he probably goes for the C4 line eventually. So, yeah, the games that I play against Will are usually pretty wild, and I usually lose my games because I missed one tiny little detail in my calculations. But that's okay. It's all part of the learning process and becoming better at calculating long lines. And usually I can calculate maybe four or five moves with a decent accuracy. But unfortunately, I can't keep up with everything. Of course, it's possible to calculate forcing lines. I can probably calculate them up to maybe six or seven moves tops, But I need some time. I'm not one of the guys who sees everything just in a flash. This is a pretty standard setup for black in this position. And the big question is, where is he going to put that bishop? Either of those, or is he not going to move it at all? If he goes for e4, I don't know. I just take it, of course. But I'm pretty sure c4 will come. And then I throw knight at him as soon as this knight comes out. I might actually go for c6 at some point, just to make sure that there's no knight shenanigans here on either d5 or b5. And then I could go for some kind of a stonewall setup. That might actually be the order of the day. Especially if he goes for knight c3 immediately. Then we go for this structure, castle, and then this bishop might actually make an entrance out there. Okay? I'll just castle, and I tend to play the opening pretty fast, especially if I know more or less the ideas that I'm going to play. So he will come to my game pretty soon, I guess. So he seems to be facing some pretty wild players in some of the other games. So it will be interesting to see how that goes. Oh, I want to change my shoes. I'll be back in a bit. Let's see how this goes. Down to two viewers again. So So it's only Tors and myself. Everybody else has left for the time being. But we'll see. Maybe the chat user view on Streamlabs is just completely fucked up. Yeah, it's entirely possible, man. But I don't give a crap about that. I'm thinking I might go for a stone wall structure here. And the stone wall is kind of problematic in some ways. I mean, he is going to drop this night in here immediately if he gets a chance. Which we meet up with knight to d7. So there will be a trade. And I will be going in here with my knight. But it'll be interesting to see how he treats this position. I know absolutely no theory in the Queen's Gambit decline, so I would probably be come way out of my depth just about immediately if I try to go for that. I have tried a couple of times to play something like the Slav defense, but I got destroyed so bad because I know absolutely no theory there and I was just eaten alive. So I have to work on that one because I want more weapons in my repertoire. But I kind of like when people play after this, if they go for this, I have started to try playing some kind of Grunfeld setup, but Will never allows me to do that. Okay, so we are into classical Dutch territory now. So I'm not going for... So, Queen e8 now. Queen e8, knight c3, knight e4. Usually white doesn't take on e4 because he doesn't want this annoyance. So, because that would give me a good chance to just secure my knight or my pawn here in a very awkward place for, because this knight is going to find no very happy places. So we have this structure set up now. So it's a big question. Do I go for e6 at e6 now? Or do I go for this? Because I kind of want to get that knight out there, if at all possible. Okay. The idea is to go out there with the queen. We have the classical Dutch here. I just wish I had reviewed this opening recently. And basically the idea here is to We want to stave off this move. When a knight comes out, this knight is coming here immediately. And after it's gone, I want to be able to play this, this, and eventually go there, because my bishop wants to dive into h3 after the queen is here. But he knows those things, of course. He has seen it probably countless times before. I don't think he is dumb enough to sack a piece for two pawns for uncertain types of compensation. I don't see that happening. So if he goes there, I will hit him here. If he goes there, I just drop my bishop back. Just defending this, and this bishop move is not a threat because I just push my pawn and he is not going to destroy his position with any silliness. Because if he tries to go for this, then I push my e-pawn into his face. So it will be interesting to see how this will go. Yeah, I bought the Killer Dutch course on Chessable. I always liked this idea of moving the forget about it pawn, as John Bartholomew calls it. And this opening has actually given me pretty good results against strong players. But I need to study better responses against the gambit lines that white can throw at me. Because I don't face them that often, so I haven't really started to dive too hard into it. But I might want to do that one day. So the big question is he going to put the knight there or here? And the Killer Dutch course is something that was written by Ginger GM, Simon Williams. And he of course advocates the classical Dutch. And there are videos that follow that course if you buy them. Hey Ole man, welcome! Welcome to the nut house here. Interesting, yeah. So he has some strange positions somewhere. Yeah, I will stream tomorrow, I guess, again, probably around the same time as I did now, maybe a little bit later, because we are having a family grill party tomorrow, and after having some nice stuff to eat, I may need a couple of hours to recuperate before I come to the stream. I'm probably not going to stream early in the day like Sladgie does. Yeah, I think that's a much better idea. I mean, the Opening Explorer on leeches is a good tool if you want to look at some basic lines that you want to study to a degree. But I think getting a course somewhere is a much better idea. And I am definitely going to go deeper into studying because I want to prepare for the fall tournament in the Kristiansand Chess Club, because I got my ass kicked in the spring tournament. Let me see, I want to open Chessable just quickly while I'm waiting for yeah, revenge indeed. Okay. The Killer Dutch rebooted. This is the chapter. I can drop the link. Yeah, I lost rating. I dropped from 1653 down to 1623. 3.5 points out of 10. The longer the games, the more prone I was to losing in the end game. So if you want to take a look at this course and the video content as well, it's well worth it, Tors. So yeah, I'm gonna have to work on getting my rating back. The rating isn't the most important part. Okay, knight c3. So, theory says knight e4. That is the line we want to take a look at. Of course, I could go for this and then try for a stonewall setup, but it always gives him access to e5, which can be quite annoying, even though we can throw knights to d7 at him to just trade those knights, and he has no good way to get this knight into the square at a later point. So let's throw this at him. Throw the ball back in his park. You have to suffer with me that I don't have any other music on this computer. I haven't transferred anything from my phone over to this. I may have to do that at some point because I would like to have some old school Halloween or Blind Guardian or Testament or any of those really powerful metal bands. But it will happen probably tomorrow early. So we'll have some energy in the streams. But I have to look at maybe some places where I can put some free to use material, because I don't really want, well, I don't really save my VOD up on Twitch anymore because there was such a lot of trouble with it. Yeah, for some reason the videos didn't save the vocal, the voice track, or the soundtrack. It was just a silent stream all through, and it was really annoying. if he had been thinking about Fianchetto in his bishop, he's not going to do that immediately, because then I just take that knight for free. That's not going to happen, so I kind of expect him to move the queen to c2. Of course, he could go for bishop to f4 even. He could go for rook to e1, he could go for e3. I might actually go for e6 just to stop any knight b5 shenanigans, if he's thinking about that. But of course now this is not going to work in tandem with this guy, because now this knight is defending back, so I can just drop this guy and then push the pawn and close off any kind of play against the c7 pawn. And of course, if you would go for something like this, and this, this, and this, then my queen is on his knight. And I will follow it up with pushing my pawn against this knight to just get it back. So, and pushing d5 is not going to work either, because I push e4, a5 immediately. So, he's gonna have to figure out something else. Immediate d5 I don't think will work for him, because I would just take this. Yeah, so yeah, this music will be on repeat throughout this stream until I get bored of it. I thought for a moment that Will was away from his computer, but he is just sitting back away from the webcam. Yeah, the music has to be good. The music has to be good, otherwise it's not worth it. Charge into this thing. But by all means, tell me if it starts to interrupt the stream. If the sound goes bad, then I'm gonna have to move it somewhere far away. Put it to the side there on my guitar amplifier. That should be enough. My wife is away in a party with some other female friends, and knowing them, it's going to be quite the experience to come and pick her up later on. So this move is going to happen soon, after the trade here, because that's going to happen if he doesn't move away. Maybe I should actually just start up a window of Google Chrome and just start up Nightbot in that one, and just take, let it just run this, it's auto DJ, or maybe run it from Firefox, I guess. Yeah, I'll do it after the CD is finished this time around. I don't know if you guys remember this particular game. you have to turn it a bit. I bought the Diamond Deluxe Edition a long time ago, where I got the Shadows of the Undrained Tide and also the Hordes of the Underdark. And I still play this game. Yeah, I got the original from a friend of mine who had gotten a cracked version of it. And I learned the basics of the game there, but I found it was so limited, the crack wasn't very good. So I decided, okay, if I can find it somewhere, I'm gonna buy it. And I found this deluxe version, and I have played it start to finish many times over. Okay, so Will is back to my game. And he knows which line this is, he knows who is playing, he doesn't even have to guess. Okay, queen to d3. That's a move I haven't seen for a very long time. It's a very rare move. So usually people play this move if they're moving the queen. But he wants to get his queen here in order to create some pressure down this diagonal. So I'm gonna have to make this move immediately after I trade on c3. So I can have the e5 push as soon as he goes for this push. Yeah, let's take it. Then I used to have a lot of computer games, but originals, but I have no idea what I did with them. They are probably in a box somewhere. The DOS version of Championship Manager back in from 92 or 3 or something like that. And also Championship Manager Italia. That was a fun one when I used the crazy formation that I used. It was just something I stumbled upon, and in the Italian game I just used it with every team. It didn't matter if I started with some small fry or some big team. I was always just destroying the opposition like crazy. They had no chance against me. It was really freaky. Just completely ignore the flanks and just play everything through the center. Three defenders, three midfielders, one attacking midfielder, and then three strikers. Just direct ball, just go crazy like some of the old English football teams, and I just completely killed them. It was fun. And I also had the Dutch and the Belgian version of it. I have to find those again. It was too much fun. But of course it was only meant for DOS or Windows early days, like Windows 95, 97, 98, 98 second edition. As soon as Millennium came, then the game crashed all the time. It was a blue screen of death after blue screen of death. So I decided to roll back to Windows 98. Millennium was a complete piece of shit. Hey, there's my son popping up in the stream. So let's see if the damn thing works. because he is a streamer as well. It's been a while since he streamed, I think, so... he plays completely different games to me. But we actually may go for a stream maybe early tomorrow. Because he discovered a game called Pokemon Chess, and I am sure that I'm going to get my ass cracked really hard in that game. So it might be an early stream tomorrow, because tomorrow is a holiday here in Norway. Send a message to my friend. Okay, so that's done. Yeah, I have... Yeah, absolutely. It will be fun to try it out. And it's going to be a strange thing to test. I'm going to play it blindly. So all he needs to do is just send me the link to the game. And maybe there's a possibility to see where the pieces can go to set up the board that way, so while you're learning how they go. Because it's very easy to get lost. Yeah. Okay, in this position, he is going to take this way. That's absolutely certain. Okay, Leeches has changed something here. The streamer's names aren't highlighted anymore in green like it used to be. I don't know if it's... a glitch in the system, or... Yeah, I was just trying to refresh it just to see if it would change. But yeah, the streamer names are not... For some reason, I have no idea why this is. I'm going to experiment in the next few days a little bit with Opera GX, or yeah, the Opera GX browser. See if it's lighter on resources than Firefox and all of that crap. But of course, in this particular stream, I only have two windows open, aside from VLC. It's just Streamlabs and one tab in Firefox. I was playing a correspondence game against Gina Rooks. She calls herself T-Boot Poop or something like that. T-Boot Poop, I think it's the name that she uses, basically as a piss take on the guys who were pissing her off in the forums. She doesn't suffer fools gladly, and they usually get some kind of rebuttal from her when she is pissed off. And I can understand that completely, because it just need not apply, you know. And we were playing a game, Karo Khan. I was playing the King's Indian attack against her, and it was just a super even game. And then she was going to offer me a draw, but she unfortunately came to this here and double clicked that and resigned the game accidentally. So in a dead even position, so it was just an accidental. So as a result of that, now I am rated 2056 in correspondence chess. Yeah, it's alright for her, but I don't like winning games in that way. I mean, if she misread the position and thought she was completely lost, I would have understood it. But she knew and I knew that it was an even position. It was just an accident. So, yeah. But ratings are there for a reason. I mean, you end up relatively even to your strength in chess. So it doesn't matter if you lose some games and win others. You will end up where you're supposed to be. I mean, my rating in classical chess here is 1978. I think I've gone over 2000 once. Just need to have a quick look at that. Let me see. Yeah, I have been 1979. That was my highest rating in this. And that was 2.5 years ago. And my best win against this IM here in the monthly classical arena. He completely fucked up against me and blundered the game away. I wasn't even playing that good at the time. So, yeah. Yeah, that's very nice. So, if he takes here, I think I'm going to make this move immediately. And if he brings this pawn forward, I think I'm just going to take it, actually. Oh, he takes with the pawn. Okay, so he wants to open up the B file and cause some issues there. If I go here, he comes here. I don't really want to take it. Thing is, I really fancy pushing here, even if it takes with the bishop, because it opens up my rook on the f file. Yeah, I mean, you need a much more powerful computer to even try for the world record. I'm going to go for this move now. D5 is not going to be a good move for him, because then I just push. Yeah, but it would run better on a really good gaming computer, because that's where you can actually take a lot of the load on the CPU and the internal memory by throwing all the graphical shit onto a good graphics card, and that's the big difference. And with a more powerful computer, you can run it on a higher graphical setting, if it's possible, that is. So, B4, F4. You will probably take it like this. Which is all right with me, because I'm going to probably throw my queen up here, or even do this first. Basically, by running out here, I am actually prepping this. Yeah, okay. But the better the graphics card, the easier it is on the rest of the computer. So I think we'll have to figure out something in that direction one day. And I can help you search for something that is going to be a killer gaming machine. Especially if my YouTube career starts taking off. But of course, I need a lot more interaction on that. More viewers, more videos, more subscribers, and all of that jazz. Strong gaming computer will also help with your intention of going into programming studies, because it will be much easier for it to compile everything you have programmed so far. Especially for testing purposes. That's a long-term project we have to set up and figure out what works best. Just want to Yeah, I think Dennis is streaming actually at the moment, so will be interesting to see what comes out of that. Because after this game, I will probably go over. Unfortunately, I can't rate him because Twitch didn't like him streaming a particular scene of the movie Apocalypse Now, because they objected to a scene where there's a pair of tits that show up. All the violence and killing didn't matter much, but it was the tits that really broke the camel's back. Opera GX is annoying because it opens up with a sound and it's driving me nuts trying to figure out how to turn off annoying shit in the settings. Turn this down. I don't give a shit about any upgrades, fuck off. Okay, he comes in with this immediately. So I'm thinking push. I don't know if he takes with the bishop or the pawn. It could be either. I just want to kill all sounds from the browser unless I'm explicitly running something from it. Taking this is not what I want to do because it opens up my king. And what I want to do is basically play e5 next. So e5 maybe the move here. So takes, 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 takes. So that's not a good option either. So if I push and then play this, I could go for this. If it takes. Pushing here, I'm defending there. If he takes, I don't really need to take back. Not immediately, anyway. I could actually take there. If he takes with the queen, then I can throw the bishop at him here. So that would be a nice option. So let's go for this. I have no idea if it's a good idea, but we have to see. Don't want any stupid wallpapers on this thing. Don't want any widgets. Browser sounds are off. Shaders. What the hell? Turn them off as well. Just turn everything off that I'm not using. So. Turn everything unessential and non-essential off. That's basically what I want to do. Need any weather widget. Dang thing. Let's make that sit there. Use my phone to accept this crap. So it's ready when I'm ready. Yeah, my wife sent me a message. She wants to get back home soon. So, I may actually ask him for a draw in this game. Yeah, she has a migraine, so I'm gonna have to cut the stream short, I think. Unless I just let it continue streaming and play on the phone while I'm driving, which is maybe not the best idea in the world. At least you will see the moves. So the stream will go on, but there will be no me, which means I'm just going to fire up the auto DJ. Okay, some of those songs have been banned from okay, so opera is not this was not the one I wanted. Smeg off updating BS. I'll just go over into this guy. So Opera GX does not support HTML5 videos, so it's good to know. Everything sitting so strangely here now. What? Okay. Everything is just fucked up. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have to drive, pick up my wife. Okay, so he is about 2 or 3 minutes away from coming to my game, so I think I will just open turn off Sludgie stream just to limit the usage of the bandwidth and go to one of my playlists, which has a lot of songs by Gary Moore or Thin Lizzy. So you have some music here in any case too, so play playlists. Probably a lot of the songs have been blocked or removed, so no worries. But at least you'll have some entertainment while I'm trying to play the game while driving. The music is clear on your end, guys. So now I have my game active there, and I can play on the phone. Okay, perfect. So I will be back in maybe 45 minutes to an hour, so there will be no commentary on the game, just me playing on the phone. So see you around, guys. Yeah.
the difference. I could probably help them set up the Hopper GX, if need be. I'm very curious what IM stands for. I'm not gonna click on it. I know just about nothing about chess, so I have no idea how this is gonna play out. Like something. Now, I am not going to be playing for him. That sounds like an absolutely terrible idea, actually. He said that he's going to be playing on his phone. However, he is driving, and I am not so sure if he's going to be able to do it. At least in time. Who knows? Not me. I do wonder what sort of moves can he make. Seems like he's able to play. There are a couple of things that Sparkle Horse can do. He could capture d6 with Queen, but risking. I don't think he would do that. That would put him at risk of being taken by Bishop. Bishop d6. Oh hey, Master Chess Dojo, my dad does not know that you have just followed, because right now he's going to fetch my mom. She's having a bit of a migraine, but I hope you enjoy, at least. just hit the 59 minute mark for Sparkle Horse. I am actually kind of curious to how this game will end up. In the meantime, I guess I could talk about... In the meantime, I guess I could talk about my stats on Duolingo or whatever. While watching this. I'm gonna get a 37 streak right now. So how are you guys enjoying the stream? Right now I'm acting as a replacement for Thomas. I'm his son, if some of you aren't. Yeah, there's a bit of a difference between me and my father. Yeah, hey. My name is Eyek, spelled E-G-I-L-L. Right now I'm just acting as a replacement for my dad because he went off to fetch my mom. So he's playing on his phone right now. Right now I'm just waiting for Sparkle Horse to do something. In the meantime, I'm playing Duolingo. Playing. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know what OTB means. I've been on the internet since I was like 5 and I have no idea what that stands for. If it's anything about chess, then probably not. Oh, no. I do not play chess, like, at all. I've played chess a couple of times on a very old computer when I was like 6 years old, and I always lost against the computer. They are. Though I'm pretty sure it was like easy difficulty. So it shouldn't even have been that hard. But then again, I was also like 6 years old. Right now I'm just on Duolingo learning some Japanese. I mean, yeah, but it's not something that I've had a major interest in. Like when Dad started streaming chess, he had been inactive for 30 years, but at that time he had experience. It was 30 years unused experience, but it was still enough experience for him to at least have some sort of advantage over people who have never played before. I have just about zero. Although, I have been a bit curious about chess. Not enough for me to actually have an interest in it, but it seems to be spiking a bit in popularity, apparently. Like, I've even seen some of my classmates play chess, and they're not the types that I would expect to have an interest in that, to say the least. It's one guy, but still. Yeah. That is very likely where it got most of its popularity.
Ever television interview was conducted just a few weeks
I have not, actually. I have never seen a single episode of Queen's Gambit. It stars Anya Taylor-Joy, right? Pretty sure it's Anya Taylor-Joy. Not entirely sure. Yeah, okay.
I don't know. I mean, Grand Slam couldn't hit a deal at all. And then a couple of the lads got bored and, you know, they left, so I was forced to go solo. The minute I went solo, people started offering me deals. I got a deal with Polydor. I got, you know, Gary asked me to do some stuff with him. I was working with Paul Hardcastle. Been writing some stuff with Rick Parfitt from Status Quo. You know, and all these things started happening to me since I went solo. But I think Maybe Grand Slam suffered the backlash from the thin Lizzy support, because obviously a band that potentially could be good compared to, you know, a band that had been around like 12 years with a string of hits, you know.
But yeah, I've never really had too much of an interest.
And Grand Slam were doing sort of smaller venues. I just don't think Grand Slam won in the comparison, so.
Also, you had the same formation with two guitar players and yourself.
I only know.
Do you think maybe people couldn't accept?
I'm pretty sure she was in a Jumanji movie.
I don't know.
Like one of the more recent ones.
You know,
there's the Queen.
But Grand Slam couldn't get a deal. You know, when the band maybe you were bad, you know, maybe people just genuinely didn't like it, but.
But yeah, Anya Taylor-Joy. I'm pretty sure she was in a Jumanji movie, not entirely sure. I just know. I mostly know her from the announcement of the Super Mario Brothers movie. Which I still haven't seen, I really should.
Do you think we'll ever see Thin Lizzy back on a stage again, or is that now something completely in your past?
There was something in the paper in the Daily Mail yesterday, I think, saying that Thin Lizzy was...
But yeah, I know that she stars as Princess Peach in...
We all keep in...
In the Mario movie.
You know, I mean, I was working with Scott and Brian Downey is...
Honestly, from what I have seen in like trailers and stuff, I'm not the biggest fan. Like, it's I'd argue it's even worse that it's Chris Pratt that's voicing Mario.
Oh, it's definitely going to be the drummer then.
But
and will this be a band featuring two guitarists again? That was kind of a Lizzie trademark.
Anya Taylor-Joy for Peach.
I don't know. At the moment, I'm just.
I don't know. Like from the trailers alone.
You know, like I'm checking out guitar players and keyboard players. And
yeah.
What I want to do is finish the album. When I get the album.
I'm not entirely sure where I want to watch the movie.
The album.
I'm.
Right. And,
did they work with
really
Paramount?
But as far as Lizzie's getting back together again, I mean.
I'm not entirely sure.
I'd like to establish like a solo career first before, you know, I start to live off past glories, you know.
You say you're putting together a band at the moment. Will that be called the Phil Lynott Band, or will there be another name for it?
I don't know, because, I mean, the album...
But I have heard good things about the Mario movie. Like, it seems to be pretty popular.
You know, minor details, like what it's going to be called.
But yeah, for voices, I'm honestly not the biggest fan of Anya Taylor-Joy's inclusion.
When I'm in a band
or Chris Pratt's,
regardless of who's up front, I like it to work. I like it to be given and take from all the musicians in the band. I don't like a dogmatic structure where I go, you play this and play the same.
I find it
kind
of weird that they didn't
like
just use the original voice actors.
Because the bass is part of the rhythm section, so it plays behind the voice or the lead guitar. So as a bass player, I like to play with the musicians, and obviously as a singer, you know, fronted, you know. So when I do get a band together, I'll be working on that basis, but probably it will be Philip Lynott and
whoever.
Mr. X, you know, whatever, yeah.
Is the album
joke.
Is the album going to feature a stable set of people on each song, or will there be special guest appearances?
I mean, yeah.
Like,
not everyone is a Marvel fanboy. I will say that I do prefer the Marvel superheroes over the DC ones, but the DC ones are still really good.
Gary and, you know, just various different people. I'll try and get people that suit the particular songs that are going to be on the album.
And what sort of material will that be? Will it be very varied?
Like, I know just about
aggressive?
The bare minimum about most of the Marvel
like
superheroes, the really
the
popular
album,
ones.
The producers that I'm going to use on the album, I'd like to go over the material with each individual producer. For example, they have Tom Dowd, who does, like, Phil Collins and Eric Clapton, and he did
Molly Hatchet, yeah.
He's been around ages now. He likes a certain songs.
You may or may not have seen...
You know,
Doctor Strange, Multiverse of Madness.
So I'll go with the songs.
I saw it in theaters. It was a pretty decent movie.
To finish off the rest of the production, I'll go with that. But in general, it should be more balanced than, say, the other solo.
I know that The Boys is very popular, but I've never really gotten the chance to get into that.
And I saw my solo albums were much softer than I was, whereas this time there should be a better balance. There should be more upfront hard stuff and a couple of balance.
I do really like the concept, though.
You've done some writing with Huey Lewis. Will any of that appear on the album?
I've done some recording with Huey Lewis. We haven't done yet. We didn't write anything together.
Yeah.
He was producing some stuff. He took me out to San Francisco. He wanted me to try one of his songs, and he liked one of the songs I'd written. So we got together and did that. And everybody seems to like it. So that may end up on the album. I'm not really sure at the moment. Mm. What I really want to do is get in and have it on tape, and then pick the best from what I've done.
Well, yeah, but I also really like the idea that superheroes were being created by a company and were basically owned by them. Like, that is a prospect that is, that can be very terrifying when you think about it. Honestly, I'm not really that much into specifically movies. Like, I do have some that I really like. For example, Treasure Planet, my all-time favorite movie. Absolutely fantastic, the visuals are beautiful. There's also Big Hero 6. I'm not really the type to cry from movies. I have done it, but even then, Big Hero 6, like the ending of it, was really moving. I haven't really watched any other Big Hero 6 stuff, like the Big Hero 6 series. I've mainly been mostly into video games, like especially Team Fortress 2 and more recently Ultra Kill. Team Fortress 2 you may or may not have heard of, it's my age. It came out in October of 2007. It's a pretty old game. Really? I mean, I get it. Not everyone plays video games, and not everyone has a lot of time to play video games in the first place. But I've always been a big fan of games. I actually do want to create, like, a business in the creation of video games, and possibly even work with other companies, like, I don't know, Valve, Nintendo, maybe Sega. Sort of like, in the same way that Ilka worked with Game Freak to create Pokemon Home, you know? Not the Generation 4 remake, though. That one was not too good. I have heard of Diablo, but I haven't heard of Talos Principle. What's that like? so it's like a portal-based puzzle game, or at least like physics-based? Ah, puzzle game of philosophy. I don't really... yeah, I really do, huh? Thomas, my dad, went to fetch his, fetch my mother. So I'm just playing as his stand-in, Thomas, basically. Puzzle games, honestly, at least in my opinion, most of Portal's popularity came from a combination of its story and the concept of, you know, thinking with portals. There's a reason why Portal, and especially Portal 2, were very popular. Oh yeah, definitely. There was, of course, the memes that came from The Cake is a Lie. But also, GLaDOS just being an absolute bitch to Shell. It's... it was really successful, and honestly, I doubt that it being a puzzle game is like one of the big reasons why it became so popular. But yeah, just got a 37-day streak on Duolingo, so that's not too bad. It's definitely a good one, though it's not one that I particularly remember. Like, I never really played any of the Portal games, but I have seen others play them. I have also sort of played Portal on the Orange Box with the PlayStation 3, but I never finished it. Have you maybe like played Portal 2? It's I think I remember really most of the Portal stuff from specifically there. Like, for example, I remember very vividly that the companion, you mean like Wheatley, the guy that is the robot that is very annoying. Yes. Yeah, I'm talking about yeah, that. Yeah, you get to comedian. I have no idea who it's voiced by. Let me see. Ricky Gervais on multiple shows. Say a broken heart can always make. Yeah, okay, he's Wheatley is voiced by Stephen Merchant. Okay. Interesting. I don't really watch too many shows, honestly. But I've done so much crying. I really hope you mean meaning of life. Oh. Seems like an interesting show, from the title alone. Complains all the time. Like, IRL or in the show? In 30 minutes? Yeah, it should be, like around that. He said like 45 to an hour. Interesting. But I have watched some shows to completion. There's Avatar The Last Airbender. There's... and its sequel series. I have watched the entirety of the original Ben 10 series. And I was absolutely addicted to watching... Ben 10 Alien Force and Ultimate Alien, the second and third series, when I was really young. Okay, I was just wondering if that could make it like en passant. The queen, but that would need that would need him to have his pawn at c5, right? Like next to the queen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, that. Yeah, that definitely. Definitely sounds fun. Maybe I should watch it. When you say show, do you mean like a comedy show, like stand up or like stand up comedy or something? Yeah, okay. Carl Pilkington. I'll try to remember that name. Yeah, okay. I guess then a good description of it would be something like a comedic documentary or something? I don't know. Could be, yeah. Yeah, probably. Shit, I just remembered. I should probably grab some ice cream. I will be right back. myself some ice cream now. Some pretty good ice cream. Usually I have ice cream on Saturdays, but I just straight up forgot to have some ice cream yesterday, so having it today. What's up? My dad is fetching my mom. So I am his stand-in for now. Right now he's playing chess on his phone. Yeah. let me guess, you were about to say that I look younger without my beard.
Thank you!
But yeah, Dad's playing chess on his phone right now, so we're able to see his moves. My day's just been fine. I woke up at like 12 o'clock today. Luckily, tomorrow here in Norway is not a school day, so I have one more. So I can still be awake for a while. Hair dye? This is my natural hair color. And right now I just had some ice cream. We usually have ice cream on Saturdays, but forgot yesterday, so here I am with mine today. Everybody. What's the head of me? But I know I'm just a picture. What I should have been, I've been. I guess while we're waiting for Sparkle Horse to do his move, I guess I'll continue on Duolingo. Or not. Ah, there we go. Yeah. I'm gonna ask, what could Sparkle, of course, do? Sparkle Force could move the rook here, but if he moves it here, he has to. That has a way to take him, and well, it'd be pretty easy to just defend here, though I don't think he'd risk a bishop. Yeah, honestly, if sacrificing a bishop wouldn't really do much for him. So I don't think that's... I don't think he's gonna move rook anyway, but still. Maybe a pawn. I mean, I guess he could move his bishop here. Then that would lead to pawn. I don't know. I'm not smart enough to understand chess. Yeah, fair point. Technically, Sparkle could trade bishops, but would that be worth it? Probably not. Stuck here. I usually don't use Duolingo with audio, even though technically I should. So I am wondering a bit on what to do here, because the katakana for wa is very similar to fu and ra. And one other. Pretty sure it's this one. Yeah, okay. Lesson on this level. Yeah, I understand that completely. Okay, he decided to go for the bishop. Interesting. Obviously not going to move for him. Like, that would be a really bad idea. I'd practically be sabotaging the man. But I do wonder if he's going to take bishop. How would it be called? C to d6? No idea. Yo, what's up? Like 3XK.
Yeah.
Right now, my dad, he is off fetching his wife. My mother, so I'm basically a stand-in for him. Yeah, okay, he decides to hand you C to D6. But yeah, hello, welcome. I'm not really in, like, I'm only Unit 5 on Duolingo, which is one of the beginner units in Duolingo, which... So, my Japanese, not the best. I can understand some words. Like, for example, konbanwa. Okay. Isn't that a good sign? Yeah, taking it slow. I'm trying to stay focused. Right now, I'm at a 37-day streak on Duolingo, so not doing too bad. Okay, yeah, hold on. The Netherlands. So, Momo, are you, like, from Japan, or are you just very knowledgeable in the language? Or, like, decent, at the very least. Ah, born in Japan. Nice. I've heard that Japan is basically workaholic central. But I do know that it's a very nice place. I've seen some pictures of, for example, Tokyo at night. What's it like there? Yeah, thought so. City that breathes day and night. As in, like, it's very busy at pretty much all times of the day, or? Honestly, I'm mainly learning Japanese so that I can watch anime without subtitles. That's just about the only reason. I guess it can be useful if I decide to create a company that works with Japanese businesses, but. Honestly, just being able to understand anime without subtitles, honestly, that'd be pretty fun to be able to do. And hey, a lot of the communities that I'm in, well, mostly the Pokemon community, but still, they have a lot of Japanese people in them, so it'd be nice to just be able to communicate to an even larger part of the community, you know?
Change of beards.
Yeah. but yeah, the anime that I'm currently watching the most is Hunter x Hunter. Very fun. Yeah. I'm going upstairs. I still have Twitch open on my computer. So.
Ah. So, Master Chess Dojo, thank you for the follow. And Momo Chess as well. So did we have a raid or something? No? Not quite. Yeah. Those ads are really annoying. I can completely agree with that. And in the style of Paschall, let's crack open a beer. Yeah. It was not very easy playing on the phone, having to stop over and over again on the road to make my moves. That was quite difficult. Not from Norway. I live in Norway, actually, but I am from Iceland. I've been working here in Norway for almost 10 years now. Next August, I've been here for 10 years. And the family moved here in May of 2014. So he goes there. He wants to fix his pawn structure. So I think. And he's also threatening this. So maybe I have to take this. I don't think I have a choice. He takes back. Then he is threatening to dive in here. I don't think I can have a choice. I really have to take this. I'm down a pawn. So yeah, I don't think I have any choice. Just have to grab that. I paused the stream on Paschall's channel. for security's sake, because can go really wrong very fast if you have too much going on the bandwidth. Not because the connection is bad, but mainly because that bloody router here is not the best.
I've got a cold, cold feeling. Just like I surround my heart.
So he is probably going to take here.
I've got a cold, cold feeling.
If I try this, he can easily just drop over here or just claim he doesn't give a shit. Because if I take, he takes with a check, I take back, and then he takes my bishop, and I can't touch his pawns. So I have to get my king out of the potential pin.
Every time this feeling
Yeah, I think Sladgie had already guessed a long time ago who he was playing. Benoni, I play that occasionally. I just don't know the theory as well there, so I have to look into that. And he never gives you a chance to play a proper Benoni because he doesn't respond to c4 with knight c3. He plays the Benoni from the white, from the black side himself occasionally, but he doesn't like to play against it. But after he takes, do I have this move? Same colored bishops, and it's going to be an interesting endgame. I just hope it doesn't come down to a time scramble, because if I feel I'm lost, I'm going to resign. I'm not going to play for the flag. Dutch can be a really fun opening, but it can also bring you a lot of misery if you misplay it somewhat. So if I go over there, he can go there. So I don't really have that threat anymore. And if I go here, he just pushes this pawn. Unless he plays the bishop here and forces the trade. This possibility, even if I go over, forcing my king. But I think that's a slightly better option for me. just have the blues running in the background, and I think I will be feeling the blues pretty soon.
You ever talk to yourself just a little bit?
If he tries to pressure me here, I just sidestep with my rook, and then I can push this pawn and have them all on dark squares. So his bishop isn't as effective against my pawns, but he is going to be effective against my king, so it's going to be a tough situation. Fortunately, I have a light squared bishop to go up against him. No, obviously not. It's good for me if he goes there and I take and then he takes here, because then he has a pick on the 7th rank and I don't really like that. So, okay, he brings the check. I think I have any other options than just step to f8. Yeah, of course not. This pawn is perpetually weak now. And he's probably thinking about bringing a rook here and here at some point. Turn off the music now, because I kind of need to concentrate here, and the music is, this music is just too crazy. I think white is slightly better here. I mean, he is a pawn up. And the only piece that needs to get developed in my position is this rook here in the corner. So I might need to move here, push, and then get the king active on the e-file. But if he goes straight to the e-file, I'm going to move straight over. Yeah, I mean, Grand Mistress Aaron. Okay, well, Ole Pauls, he is another streamer, Icelandic guy. I think he lives in Selfoss on the south coast of Iceland. Well, not very close to the coast, actually, about 30 kilometers, something like that. Okay, so he goes for this move. So he doesn't want me to bring my bishop in here. I think I have to really go for this now. But is that any good? Because he is probably planning to push here. A at some point. He might double up behind and try to give me some headaches. But is this going to be any good? To get my king active. At least I'll go here and offer him a draw. I mean, if he rejects it, then it's okay. I think he has probably a pawn and a half advantage here, at least. Yeah, my son is streaming occasionally. It's been a while since he streamed last. I just hope he doesn't flag on me. That would be a travesty because he has a much better position. I mean, if I see him go down to like 5 seconds on the clock and still not on, I'm going to resign the game because he is better. I don't want to win games on the clock, not like this. Yeah, okay, he accepted it. Yeah. I want to check what does Blowfish say. Yeah. That's what I thought. About a pawn and a half. And that is only by finding this move. I mean, I would probably lift to be able to grab this. Yeah, the engine says rook e1, b6. Or rook c to e7, double up, rook e3. Bishop e4 to trade the bishops. Yeah, this is what I expected, kind of. Just over a pawn and a half that he has an advantage. But yeah, that's how the cookie crumbles, guys. I'm not going to do any in-deep analysis of this game. So what does Blowfish say about our game? I had 5 inaccuracies, he had 3 and 1 mistake. Okay. So, the engine hates F5. The engine hates the Dutch. Stupid engine. So, G6, no, G3 I mean. So this is basically just transposing into the classic variation, even though the engine calls it the Fianchetto attack, it's basically just the classical at this point, just a different move order. And the engine doesn't like this move for some reason. It likes to say that D6 is better. In a way, it may be. But yeah, yeah. Yeah, the engine hates a lot of openings. Queen D3 is not best. D6. E5 is not the best. Should have just taken, according to the engine. Okay? Okay, so if I do as the engine says, takes, takes. I'm wondering if this is the plan. What does Blowfish say about that? Yeah, the Leningrad variation of the Dutch is G6 instead of E6. But I just don't know the theory there, so I don't dare go into that kind of thing. And the engine says knight c6. Okay. And then c5. I'm kind of. And then bishop d7. I don't like that variation. I like this one more. It was kind of a way to muddy the waters. Yeah, thanks man. Thanks for the access. I need to work on that. But at this point, I mean, we are still, he took there. And for me, taking on e4 makes a whole lot more sense. But the engine just says this, knight c6. D takes e. F takes e4 is the worst of the three moves that are lined up. It actually suggests this move might be interesting because that means I can dive into c5, and the knight can be a pretty problematic piece there because it defends this, hits the queen, and hits this. Yeah, I know. I mean, from 2.1 up to 2.7, and then the last one that the engine suggests is queen h8, the king h8. I mean, that doesn't mean nothing. I didn't like that move, but this one was the move that I liked the most. So takes, takes. Now the engine wants knight d7. Rather than knight c6. Doesn't like this for some reason. Yeah, I mean, I'm a human, not an engine, so I just don't like engine analysis too much, because the engine is a scumbag, as a known streamer has said many times. Yeah, Gotham Chess doesn't like the engine like that, so yeah, the engine likes this more. Yeah, knight d7, rook e1, knight c5, queen d4. And then queen h5. Okay. That's an interesting line. Yeah, Gotham is an acquired taste. I like some of his stuff, but some of his stuff I don't like. So I'm kind of on the fence there, but I don't like his streams. I feel they are quite toxic, but I have watched quite a bit of his YouTube videos. I think they are much better, but the streams are horrible. I just don't go there. Of course, he is on the wrong chess side as well. So, so knight c6, the engine was not a fan. Bishop f4 was an understandable move because I was just basically threatening to take this or forcing to take and then trade off. I would be a pawn down, but in any case I would be giving pressure to those here. Yeah, absolutely. Stay away from the dark side. So, bishop f5, the engine was not much against that. It's wants bishop f6. Yeah, I didn't see that. That's a freaky move. Because he can't take, his queen would be hanging. That's interesting. Rook f2 e1, then knight takes e5. I mean, I have four pieces on this pawn. Yeah, feel free to join the Discord, guys. And this stream will end up on YouTube, despite my absence for a long period during the game. So I could really use more subscriptions and all of that stuff. You know that algorithm crap that requires you to have more or less endless amounts of subs and endless amounts of likes. I can make do with just the subs. But it's all up to you guys. But I went for this. Queen d5 check, king h8. And then he traded, and the engine hated that move for some reason. Rook takes, takes and takes. And takes and takes. Okay, the engine is not the biggest fan of this move. It's not, yeah, it's in the top five, but it's not the best one. And I have no option, I have to take back. The engine wants bishop e6. But I thought rook c7 was a better move because I wanted flexibility for my bishop. Yeah, well, the chat is not added to the stream for more than maybe that's which is seen on the screen. Okay, rook c7 is climbing slightly. And he did not see the best response to it, which was bishop d5. Yeah, he did that, of course, yeah. So here, check. King f8, best move. So I am actually finding some decent moves here. Rook f2 d1 is an inaccuracy on his behalf. Okay, bishop g6 is the best move according to the engine, and then he only has 0.8 or 0.7. Yeah. Oh well, it is similar. I just thought activating my rook on this file was the best move, and I would play that again. So yeah, this is where it ended in a draw. But it was a tough game. Yeah, it is pretty similar. It is pretty similar. So, let's see. Who should we raid then? I think I have to call it a night. I'm getting quite tired and I will stream tomorrow with my son. So, this would be a good time to call it, I think. So yeah, Thinker Teacher is on, and there's another guy I like, Rengo87. I think I'm gonna rate him this time. He is a fun character, so is going to bounce over to his stream quickly on the other computer and then send the rate his way. Okay, so have a nice one, guys. Thank you for joining me in the stream and following, and see you in the next one. Goodbye.